Hello everyone, this is Fasir Rahman. Got a new video for you people on the topic of weighted average cost of capital and marginal cost of capital. Here the problem has given, we'll see how to solve that. A company has the following specific cost of capital along with the indicated book and market value weights. Types of capital, cost, book value weight, market value weights. Okay, under the type of capital, equity, preference share, long-term debts. Their cost has mentioned, their book value weights has mentioned, market value weights has mentioned. Calculate weighted cost of capital using book and market value, the first one. We need to find out book value weights as well as market value weight. Again, weighted average cost, we need to find out weighted average cost of capital using book value weights and market value weights. Second one, calculate the weighted average cost of capital using marginal weights. If the company intended to raise the needed funds using 50% long-term debts, 35% preference share and 15% retained earning. Again, in this particular problem, here book value weights has given, market value weights has given, marginal weights has given. Okay, where this 30 50 35 and 15, we'll see how to solve this particular problem. I want to tell you one thing, we will be having two types of problems in weighted average cost of capital. In few problems directly weight is going to be given, in few problems they are going to give you the full book value in lakhs or thousands. We need to divide it and get that weights. Inshallah, in the next problem I will be showing you how to undergo for that, but presently with this particular problem it is okay. The weights has given, with the help of this weights itself we will be doing. Let me see. Yeah, computation of weighted cost of capital using book and market value weights. Okay, we are computing book value weights and market, with the help of book value weight and market value weight we are finding out weighted average cost of capital. WCC, weighted cost of capital. Book value weights, the heading has given. Now we will be having four columns: source of capital, book value weights, cost, then total cost. Now whatever the data has given in the problem on the top, the same is going to be copied, like equity, preference share, long-term debts, equity, preference share, long-term debts. Okay, then book value weights, this book value weights 0.50, 0.20, 0.30, same. Then cost, their cost is going to be mentioned. Then this two, then in under this particular total cost, when we multiply this two, we will be getting this. Okay, this thing, then we need to add up all, we will be getting this answer. Okay, 0.141. this is about book value weight, WCC for book value weight. Now we need to undergo for the market value weights. Source of capital, the same method, source of capital, then market value weights, cost, total cost, equity, same, preference share, long-term debts, the same as copied. Then for the market value weights, the same market value weights as copied, 0.58, 0.17, 0.25. okay, then cost, the same cost, 0.18, 0.15, 0.07, this thing has copied. Then this two has multiplied, we got total cost. Then we need to add up all, we will be getting our answer, WCC for market value weight. Okay, WCC for market value weight, this thing. Our first part is over, we have done with. Now we need to undergo for the second part. For the second part, we need to undergo with the marginal weights. There we have undergone with the book value weights and market value weights. The same process is going to be done for the marginal with the help of marginal weights. Again, computation of weighted cost of capital using marginal cost. Again, marginal cost. Then marginal cost has written sources of capital. The same whatever has mentioned over here in the we will be copying, like here. Calculate the weighted average cost of capital using marginal weights if the company intended to raise the needed fund using 50% long term debts. Okay, long term debts 50%, 0.50. Then preference shares 35%, 0.35. Retained earning 15%, that is 0.15. Okay. Retained earnings 0.15, preference share 0.35, long term debts 0.50. The same as written, their cost, the same cost which has given in the problem. Okay, the cost has mentioned, whatever the cost has mentioned, we have copied same. We multiplied both of them. We got the this answers. With this particular answer, what we need to do, we need to add up all. We will be getting this answer. This is our WCC for marginal cost. Okay. I believe you people have understood. Thank you very much for watching.